So we've got our quorum. So I'm going to call the meeting, or we have to call the meeting to order, do agenda first. I always forget. Roll call, right? Or I'll call the meeting to order and then Amanda, can you do our roll call, please?
Yes. Absolutely. Thank you. Board member Alexander.
Here.
Thank you. Board member Sohi.
Here.
Vice chairperson Ketchum.
Here.
Chairperson Harden.
Here.
And board member O'Malley is absent today.
All right, perfect. So, sorry, I'm getting my brain set here, guys. So next item is going to be, is it our consent calendar?
Public comment.
Oops. Oh, public comment, sorry.
Looking at Amanda going, I'll let Amanda do this. I will sit back. Sorry.
We actually do have approval of the agenda this time around. So if we could let you ask for a motion for approval of the agenda, that would be great.
Okay, perfect. Does anyone have a motion to approve the agenda?
I'll move to approve.
I'll second.
Perfect. Okay, so we've got a first from Dina and a second from Amr for approval of the agenda.
Absolutely. Would you like me to roll call?
Yes, please.
Certainly. Board member Alexander?
Yes.
Board member Sohi?
Yes.
Vice chairperson Ketchum?
Yes.
Chairperson Harden?
Yes.
Thank you. Motion passes.
Sorry, my computer just decided to crash, so I'm reopening. That's what I had open. One second, guys.
That's okay. We all have an adjustment period, so.
Yeah, it's like.
I'm still adjusting. All good.
Okay. So first item on the agenda, we've got the Atascadero Equity Mural Project update and sponsorship approval.
Correct. And Zoe Zappas was going to be presenting that. I don't see Zoe there quite yet. What I would do is make a motion to make it number two and bump up Ms. Pitt to number one. Or not a motion, but make a recommendation to the board.
Okay. So yeah, I'll recommend that we move that to number two. Is it everyone good with that?
I'm fine.
And if we could back up, only because we didn't open public comment and we haven't approved the consent calendar yet. So if we could work those in really quickly, that would be lovely.
Absolutely.
Thank
you. Okay. Do we have a motion to, do we need public comment first or consent calendar first?
Public comment was listed first, so
that would be perfect. Good. All right. Do we have any comment from the public?
Yeah. One quick hello.
Hi, Josh.
Hi there. Real fast, the Zoe may be delayed because I was asked to put in a password today. I don't know if all of you were. So maybe she doesn't have the password. Maybe I'll text that to her right now.
It's on the agenda, at the top of the agenda. Let me go ahead and share that again so everybody has it. So.
No further comments. Thank you.
Perfect. So without any other public comment, I think we can move on to a motion to approve the consent calendar. Anyone have a motion for that?
Yes, I motion to approve the consent calendar.
I will second. And good job, Amanda. We were testing you.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm Thanks, glad Amanda. I passed.
So we've got a motion by Karina and a second by Amr. Can we get a roll call on that, please, Amanda?
Absolutely. Board member Alexander.
Yes.
Board member Sohi?
Yes.
Vice chairperson Ketchum?
Yes.
And chairperson Harden?
Yes.
Thank you. Motion passes.
Perfect. Okay. So then we were recommending we move agenda item number one down and start with the California Mid-State Fair, and we were okay with moving on to that. So can we start with that? We're good now? All right. So let's do... We've got the California Mid-State Fair sponsorship review as our first item.
So this is just to bring back to everybody the California Mid-State Fair sponsorship and what we participated in for the fair this year. In the past, the fair had all the buses coming to Atascadero, so we had about four different buses, but this year, because of COVID, the buses went away, and therefore the sponsorship is half the cost. So we split that cost with the TBID, and in splitting the cost with the TBID, we were able to continue doing that and also putting out there a promotion with Visit Atascadero and working with Ashley and the team over at Verdun for folks to come see two of the concerts. Little Big Town was a concert giveaway that we had. And then we also had Jason Carullo, a family four pack to the fair for that. We also were able to be involved with the Apple Pie Judging Contest. We were able to include Bramble Pie Company along with A-Town Humble Pie and be a part of that. The Craft Brewery Awards ended up becoming more the Distillery Awards, and that's where they shifted that sponsorship to the distillery because the brewery side didn't come together like they had wanted. So they had applied our involvement that would be brewery with distillery, which makes sense because of Central Coast Distillery. We got our regular equestrian center signage. We had our text to win ticket promotion that we had worked with Tom Capuri on to add that to it. That promotion giveaway was done at the beginning of the fair and was part of like winning concert tickets and that sort of thing. So we were able to get an additional promotional tie-in with the fair and be involved there. And then we had also our sponsorship announcements through the fair, our signage at the Equestrian Center and all of that. So the sponsorship, definitely we did what we could. They had about 220,000 people attend. I think normal attendance is closer to 700,000. I was looking for that to see where the attendance numbers are. They didn't really provide that in their press release recap, which I don't blame them because it's such a different number. But coming back after COVID, it was nice to stay involved at the fair, be involved, you know, have us present there was a lot of fun, as well as, you know, staying top of mind with everybody as they came to visit, because there's a lot of visitors coming to the fair again this year. So next year it'll be much more bigger and better, and all of that is the hope as we work through COVID and all the things with that. But are there any questions that the board might have?
So Terry, the only question I have is, I know the buses were running in Paso. What was the reason they couldn't do them for Atascadero?
They had two buses running in Paso, or two bus stops. Normally they have like five or so. Yeah. Okay. The volume of buses wasn't there. So with COVID, they could only keep the two buses and they could only keep it for Paso Robles, is what had happened. So yeah, it kind of went away with the fair. Same with Showcase of Cities. That went away with the fair, or not with the fair, but with COVID. Coming back from COVID type of thing, much more scaled down version of the fair, obviously, with the entertainment part as well. So yeah, that's what we were pushing, and he had us on a list for maybe one bus, but it just didn't come together. They just didn't have the ability to do that this time.
Okay.
And Terry, they're anticipating though the buses coming back next year, right? Yes. As far as we know.
So it should be a full $15,000 sponsorship next year versus half that. So we'll have much more involvement. We'll have the beer night will come back, because both the beer night and the wine night, being jazz night and the craft beer night, those went away as well because they have 300 tables and they have a waiting list for tables just for jazz night, much less the beer night. And that all went away because they couldn't justify cutting half the tables, and who are they going to cut, because they're all VIPs at this point and they've had these tables forever. So that went away also, but that will come back. We'll be involved with that, so it'll be a much stronger sponsorship like we had in 2019. That's all I have to report. Any other questions, Karina or Umar?
I just wanted to do a quick note, Terry, for our, so with the giveaway, we had tickets, as Terry mentioned, and so we gave two ticket packages away in social media, and so we had over 160 people enter to win. It was a really quick kind of 1 week giveaway, so I just wanted to make sure that the board knew that statistic or reported on that result as well.
absolutely your compliment to this because I didn't have those details.
Do you know, Terry, are they going to be, because I think last year was the anniversary year, right? And then this year they had to do a skimmed down version. Are they talking about hitting it big next year? Or is it just way too soon for that?
I would say, I mean, I haven't heard, you know, how they're going to go into next year at this point, but as soon as I know that they'll be getting with us on sponsorship again, and we'll be able to bring Tomka Fury into one of our meetings and really talk through what the plan is. But I haven't heard like going into next year yet, what that looks like. Very good. Anything else to add? Which one was more popular, Ashley, Jason, or Little Big Town, as far as the number of, you know, response? Yeah,
increase. It was Little Big Town. Little Big Town had 91 and Jason Derulo had 69.
Okay, that's good to know.
Yep.
Yay. I saw that Little Big Town was their biggest selling concert too, in general, out of all of them. So that was their highest really, attended one.
Really fun. I got to go.
Yay.
Oh, yeah?
Very good. All right. Well, this is receive and file, so there isn't a motion or anything. So we can see if maybe Zoe is in the house. And any updates there, Josh?
Not yet in, right? Okay. So since she's not in, can we move on to the next item and table hers for the end, hoping she comes in? Is that, we still keep doing that?
Yeah. I'm looking.
Okay, perfect. All right.
You're fine to do that.
Okay, perfect. Just want to make sure before we moved on.
So we have record of that.
Okay, so next item on the agenda, we've got the Future Destination Management and Administrative Services Ad Hoc Committee update with Karina and myself. Karina, did you want to talk about it since you kind of put together the document, or do you want to kind of just both go at it?
Yeah, we could both go at it. I'm working from a pretty small, my laptop right now. I don't have it up on my other computer because I'm at home. So, sorry.
Can you see it on the screen at all?
Yes, I can see it.
I don't know if it's big enough. I can go a little higher and if that's helpful.
Oh, what am I doing here? Okay, I mean, I'm just gonna be through it, right?
I jumped ahead. I can go back to the staff report if you wanna start there.
Yes, okay, so this is what Tricia and I put together as far as the recommendation, review and provide staff direction for the support needs and future direction for destination management services with an RFP/RFQ to explore available options. The discussion was the Atascadero Tourism Business Improvement District Board is in the beginning stages of reviewing the current scope of work for destination management services that was formerly fulfilled by Big Red Marketing. The objective is to develop a new plan for destination management services in the July 21st, 2021 special meeting. An ad hoc committee was assigned to report on what would work best for the ATBID. The two ATBID board members assigned to the ad hoc committee was Patricia Harden and Karina Ketchum. The committee's goal was to research and purpose a plan that will work for ATBID based on the current needs of the tourism board. The ad hoc committee is presenting the draft of the administrative services for ATBID to review as the first attachment on what would be required to fulfill the administrative duties.
Okay, and I'll move to the attachment and that way everybody can see.
Perfect.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You want to continue, Patricia? Sorry,
I'm No, you're good. We met with Terry. We went through kind of everything that Big Red had been doing and tried to pare down really the administration support portions of it, because they did have sort of the destination management in there and a couple other things that we know overlap with Verdin and what Terry's doing. So we really tried to just bring it down to the important parts of it. Came up with sort of the admin sides where they're doing, you know, agenda creation and all that. And then Terry brought up a couple other, really the big thing I think Terry was that we could take off Terry's plate that they could also do would be the anytime a new business enters the market or one leaves the market, they can update the website. And that was just a thing that Terry had mentioned would be helpful to her. So these bullet points right here are sort of the core ones that we think were the best options for what we would need from administrative support. So obviously posting the agenda and getting out the packet, working alongside the city to do the press links, all the hard copy filing in the archival files, anything ongoing with COVID and some of the updates with that, which we know are going to keep happening, the minutes approval, all of that kind of stuff. Basically, I mean, you know, all the admin part plus what Terry had mentioned. And it really, to me, and I think I don't, Karina can say what kind of what she was thinking, it cut out a lot of what was in Big Red's original contract.
Yeah.
From my point of view, and really pared it down.
Yeah, I mean, I think, yeah, I mean, the main reason why, well, in my opinion, the main reason why Big Red didn't want to take on the task anymore is just because it was a big admin role, which I totally understand. So looking for something specific with just those admin duties is what we determined to be the most useful.
What I want to just mention too, to be real super clear with this particular draft is really with the administrative support at the top is something that both Patricia and Karina mentioned is to be very clear, as well as us being very clear on what this would entail. It wouldn't be marketing. There's not marketing.
Exactly. We don't want to go into it with somebody thinking there's a chance for the marketing piece to come their way or a chance for the destination management to come their way. We want it to be very clear and transparent from the beginning that it is an administrative support role.
Yep.
So that there's no confusion.
And Umber took a break, I think. So we might want to pause for a minute. I would recommend doing that. That way, Amanda.
We can get his questions and things.
Absolutely.
Is there an official way to pause it that we have to?
We could recess it for 5 or 10 minutes for everybody and then bring it back.
Okay. So can we do a, I think we, like a 10-minute recess? That'll give them a little bit of extra time.
Sure. So come back at 3?
Yeah, let's do that.
Perfect. Okay. I'm going to stop the recording and stop the share right now so we have that, give him that. Okay. So.
Perfect. Okay, so welcome back, everyone. I think we, Umber, I don't think you missed too much. We were pretty much just discussing the admin roles and what we had kind of gone over. I think we're at the point where, does anyone have kind of questions on it or on what we've kind of put together and what we provided from the board, at least, questions from the board?
I do not. I heard you say that there was some overlapping and you were able to water it down a little bit, whittle it down for mainly just an admin role.
So we really wanted to focus on the admin portion of it because there was so much overlap between what Verdin's already doing fantastically at and what Terry does that we really wanted to be transparent that we're focusing on admin with this.
Okay, that sounds great.
I agree.
Perfect. So any other questions from the board?
And then I heard you say the RFP, RFQ process. Is there, sort of a timeline on that? Or is that starting immediately? Or I guess you're waiting for this before we can start, right? This approval?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay. Sounds great. Well, thank you to you and Karina for doing all this work. That's for sure.
We are happy to help. Okay, so do we have any public comment or do we need public comment on this one?
I just have a quick question. Terry,
there
was one item that was specific. So for example, when we would get a request from SLOCAL for say, about what hotels are offering specific specials around a holiday. And Big Red would send out a e-blast through the MailChimp because we have a specific list to our hotel partners. So would that work when we have a specific request or we need to get information out to the hotel partners with this person, or would you like us to help out with that, or what would you prefer?
What you all can do is in this RFP draft that we have, just like Karina and Patricia did right here, works to update Visit Atascadero website to add new businesses and assures all areas are updated on the site. You can be real specific with those type of things that come up. Some of that, this is all city stuff that, you know, we have as admin. But really works hand in hand with Amanda, you know, the posting of the agenda packet, all the pieces that go with it, the exhibits that have to be documented and whatnot. But in this like whole event coordination part where we talk about occasionally attends tour and travel related conferences or trade shows on behalf of Visit Atascadero, manage follow-up and leads generated from tour and travel. In that part is to me where you could add in there, there will be times where we have to get out to the hoteliers because that's very admin. It goes to lodging partners. So it's very admin. And that's something to be as specific, but vague enough or as specific, but broad enough where if there's something new that's added, it falls in that admin part and it's not on Verdin to do that.
Got it. Yeah, it's probably, I would say on average about 4 or 5 times a year in total, but it's just kind of like updates on specials, sending out survey links, things like that to have board hotelier communication.
So we'll add survey links and why don't you do this in sending a quick, maybe in chat or even an email that talks about those pieces and those could be added in the RFP.
Great. I will send that to you right now.
Okay.
Thanks.
Perfect. Any additional public comments?
I think Ashley, can I ask one more question about that? Are we still in public or do I have to wait for public to close? Can I talk?
I think we can close public. If nobody has any additional public, we can close it and you can talk.
You can still talk,
Amr. Awesome. Well, if Amr was going to talk, I'll just jump in.
Brought up the event coordination because I was just wondering about, so for things like if we participate with CalSAE and, you know, IPW, things like that, would Verdin be the one representing us like in those capacities? Okay, great. That was my only last question.
Absolutely. It makes sense that that would stay with Verdin. I can always go. Just kidding.
Just kidding. And that would work too. I was just, yeah, that would absolutely work. But
no, it'll be more Verdin because they're there. So they're, yeah.
Excellent. Okay.
These are good things though. There is something else I wanted to make sure that you all see. Whenever we have a board member changes with board members and that sort of thing, that also would fall on the administrative side and voting in a new board member if a board member terms out or whatever. That's all covered in here as well. Because they coordinate the lodging owners meeting to bring on an advisory board member.
Perfect. Okay, any additional public comments? And close the public comment on this one. Do we have any final board member comments or questions? So I think we need a motion on this one, right? So we need.
Yes.
Does anybody want to make a motion to accept, probably pending the Verdin update, right? We're going to update their little.
Yeah, we need staff direction on this, what you want us to do, if we're gonna go to RFP, what we're doing type of thing.
So, I can make a motion. I normally look at, I like to look at the agenda items so I can word it the right way.
Yeah.
Well, and I'm glad that you asked as well. I wasn't certain, and that is probably board direction on whether or not we're moving forward with drafting an RFP based on what's here. So if we could get that clarified, whether or not staff is amending this based on specific things that you would like to see changed. So if we could capture that, that would be helpful.
Well, I mean, I move to approve moving forward with the recommendation of this ad hoc committee as far as the scope of work for the destination management company that comes in with whatever changes necessary with Verdin, if I said that right. Amanda, we usually wait for you to reword our motion so it's the right way. That might be challenging, but.
Well, I think that you captured that. If that's where we're going with the minor changes that Verdin is going to make, that's perfect.
Perfect. Do we have a second on that?
I heard a second. Who is that?
Yeah, it was me.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. So we've got the motion by Amr and a second by, was it Karina? I couldn't tell on my end.
Yeah, it's
okay.
Karina.
Okay, perfect. Can we get a roll call on that one?
Certainly. Board member Alexander.
Dean, are you there?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you. Board member Sohi.
Yes. Sorry.
Thank you. Vice Chairperson Ketchum.
Yes.
Thank you. And Chairperson Harden.
Yes.
Motion passes. Thank you.
Perfect. Okay. So we want to move back to the equity mural project update with Zoe, correct?
Correct.
Perfect. All right. You can take it away.
All right, Zoe. I'll move to pictures.
I like it.
there you go.
Terry, are you giving the update or am I?
They have you give an update on your murals for sure. Because you're here. And you'll talk about it the best.
Okay. I don't know. You did a pretty good job in the staff report, but so the Equality Mural Project has been working for about 2 years. On like the behind the scenes stuff, just getting everything ready, partnered with SLOCAC, which is the SLO County Arts Council down in SLO, but they represent the whole county. And we have secured funding for the first 5 murals. We have locations for all of those 5. And we're just looking to expand it. We've completed our first 2. So we have one on the side of the Brew Coffee House, which went so well. It was done in 7 days. And this woman came all the way from Pennsylvania. She was moving her family out to California in the midst of painting this. So it was kind of like a wondrous feat that she did this. So Brandy, she was our first muralist and she finished that in 7 days. It's on the side of Brew. During the process, it was really incredible to see the impact for business right away. Like people are super interested. They get out of their cars, they ask questions. And these muralists essentially are these people promoting a Atascadero while they're doing it, even though they don't live here, some of them. It's really, really great community involvement. Brandy also did like a paint by numbers kind of situation. So she was able to involve a lot of community members. And it was just like a really wholesome, lovely activity. It was really hot, but it was really, really fun. And then we just completed our second one. What was this? 2 weeks ago now. And Isaac York, he's based out of San Luis Obispo, and he was a teacher at the SLO Classical Academy, and he is getting his teaching credential and going back to school and all of that. So he did it in 2 weeks. And was juggling his schooling program and then coming back out in the evenings to paint while it was cooler and all of that. And he had some community support as well. We were partnered with the Diversity Council through the Chamber
to help paint the base coat and some of these larger swaths of paint. So it's like turning out to be a really lovely community involvement kind of piece. And then also I'm already seeing some circulation with people on social media. Gabby from Babies Babble just posted a picture of her two young girls posed in front of the mural with their Negronti Creamery ice creams in hand. And we reposted it on our website and also our social media channels. And and it sounds like Verdin also shared it. Ashley, is that right?
Yep, we share anything like that on Visit Atascadero social channels too. So we keep an eye out.
Cool. Yeah, so that's turning out really well. This one I think is going to lend itself really well to like selfie backdrops and just general photos and for people on social media. So I'm anxiously awaiting more and more people posing in front of that and waiting for the moment to post those when they happen. So I'll be sure to tag Verdin in it as well whenever I see that. But we did attribute the first mural that Brandy Pippen did with TBID, because you guys were actually the first ones to donate to the project. And I wanted to make sure that we honored that right away. So we had the opportunity to talk about TBID on KSBY. The Tribune, New Times also got that. And then where else? Oh, we mentioned that we had a mini event once COVID kind of cleared up a little bit. We had an event at the Printery and we mentioned it there as well. So looking for further partnership here. Again, I said that we actually have six locations, five are fully funded, and we're looking to continue the project and keep it moving. So that we can get a critical mass to get to make it make sense to have a digital walking map hosted on the Visit Atascadero site soon. So that's kind of it for my explanation. Are there any questions?
Anyone from the board have any questions?
Zoe, is it only the Visit Atascadero site that it's on? Are there other sites that it's being showcased on?
That's a great question. We have not partnered with anyone else to host the digital walking map. We can talk about that. If you want exclusive rights to that, that's open for discussion. Or if you wanted to boost traffic by having it other places, we can talk about having it on the Equality Mural Project website, as well as anyone else. If there's someone that you would prefer to see it on their website, I'd be happy to talk about that as well.
That sounds good. I wouldn't know about exclusive rights. I'd probably kind of defer to Terry and Ashley on that and see, like you said, to get further reach. But I was just wondering about that and what the initial what was the initial amount that was approved way back in the beginning? Was it 5,000 at that time also?
It was 5,000 at that time. So we're just asking, I think Tom O'Malley mentioned that he would be open to funding a second one. He said to come back in the next quarter, but it's been several quarters since I visited you last. So here I am.
I can say, and I'll defer to Ashley after this in reference to the tourism piece and really wanting to have a mural tour and be able to showcase Atascadero from a tourism destination and giving that things to do and what to check out when they're here and really getting them circulating around downtown, that if there's a way to have some sort of exclusivity with a walking tour, to me makes sense to really hang our hat on. But that's me talking, kind of Ashley started talking about it first, so I don't want to steal her thunder on this. So I am going to defer to her right away. But that's something I feel like if there's an opportunity there, that might be of interest for this group.
Yeah, I think, originally Zoe and I talked about how we'd love to build this to be interactive on our website. We just wanted to make sure we have a handful of the murals completed. So we're sending people to, you know, a handful before we say there's a tour here and then you can only visit two. So we want to make sure that we have enough to pique curiosity, encourage, you know, people visiting. I think the one thing I loved about the post recently with the two girls is the dedication to placemaking. This is a huge piece. Art and culture is a huge piece, a huge pillar for tourism. People really look for that. I know in other destinations like Nashville, Tennessee, it's all of these different, you know, different art murals. I was just in Portland. That's wild with art murals. So I think, you know, if we have the ability to build an interactive map, we could even do some really cool audio tour. Maybe Zoe could be our host because she's been her host for so long. I can't put you on the spot there, Zoe, but you know,
happy to do
some really cool audio walking through, and then we could build out. That's kind of the vision I had in my head. So once we have, you know, a handful, at least I'd love to get five. Once we have that kind of completed, then we can really build that out with our developer to create something really cool on the site. And we can have a link on it on the homepage that directs people to the full map, have it a whole dedicated page, and then we could really do some public relations effort around that too.
Yeah, and I'll jump in here again. So I have a clarifying question, perhaps. We have two completed for the Equality Mural Project, but we also have two that we did that we completed previously with Z Villages as a separate project. And then I know that the Artery's got a rotating mural program that rotates yearly. So that would put us at five. I don't know if we're looking to include all murals in town, but that would be an interesting way to maybe reach a critical mass to make it make sense.
Yeah, I think the thing on that, Zoe, too, is if we can incorporate all of those, because I like the idea of having this as the Equality Mural Project, could those two additional murals be part of that umbrella? Because it has the, like the one behind Colony, yeah. That's, you know, really speaks to the movement, but I don't know how, I mean, are we good with the other two?
It can totally be included. It's just not really a part of the original intent for the Equality Mural Project specifically. So I would be cautious because it might be confusing, you know, the Equality Mural Project is dedicated to adding 10 murals to downtown in addition to what is already here. And right. So if you include those older ones, people might be confused. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, maybe you and I can talk offline and we can kind of work out those little details to see. Because if it is something that we can go ahead and get started on, we could begin building it out and then and see what that looks like.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, that'd be great.
What's the timeline, Zoe, on so you've got the locations of the other three here. Is there a timeline on when they'll be completed? I have like no concept of how long it takes to do these things. So
yeah.
I know it's a massive undertaking.
It's a great question. So we have one permitted and ready to go whenever the artist's schedule kind of clears up. So I'm thinking estimated probably around September sometime. So she's slated to get started soon. There's another one that is already under agreement for the tunnel under the 101 freeway. That is due to start October 1. And then we have another one that's kind of pending a concept rework. Her concept was very square. And so the wall that we got is really rectangular. So she's reworking her concept completely. We should have that back and then I'll need to get that permitted. So that may be around end of September, early October.
And then for the sixth one that you're asking for this one, do you guys have a location in mind for the next one yet? Or is it sort of up in the air?
I do have a location in mind. It's really preliminary phases for that one.
Okay.
I had an initial conversation with the property owner and he was interested in giving that wall to us. It's a huge wall, so it would be a huge undertaking, but yeah, that one's in the works as well.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. And an artist lined up for that wall as well. So I'm just trying to get the ducks in the row for that one.
Yeah, makes sense. Thank you. Any additional board questions?
Can you say who the other people are that have participated financially on these other murals?
Yes. So we have Pacific Western Bank, which is based here in Atascadero. They have a branch here. I have two from the school district. That one was special because Clark is a teacher at the high school and he's going to be painting under the freeway, which was previously first right of refusal was given to the high school for that piece. So I've already coordinated with all the parties involved there and we have permission to paint there. That one was really, I really loved that one. That was like one of my favorites. So I'm looking forward to that one coming together. So we have two funded by the school district. And then we had a partial funding from a city council member and a private investor.
I know there's not like a downtown association anymore. Is there any, there is? Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah. So the bid is being hosted by the chamber now, and Josh can probably speak to this a little bit more, but I was the chair of the business improvement district for the businesses downtown. I have resigned, which kind of leaves it on the shoulders of the chamber to maybe facilitate a little bit. And it looks like it's headed that direction. I have put in an I have submitted for funding through the bid so that that piece is also being processed.
Okay. And I was just wondering about that for the opportunity to maybe, for partial sponsorships in the future or matching sponsorships for, you know, other businesses downtown that it would behoove.
Yeah, that would make sense. Yeah. And we can do something like that, no problem. We like to do events kind of around a matching donation situation, which is just like a little bit more work on our end, but that's totally workable.
Perfect. Any additional board comments or questions? Not, we can move to, you're good? Okay, any public comments or questions? Oh, okay, so we can close public comment. Do we have a motion from the board? Does anyone want to make a motion regarding Zoe's ask?
Do we know where we're at, like within our budget as far as a project like this, where it comes out of? And I know that the money's, you know, not coming in. Well, I shouldn't say that, but as far as our budget, you know what I mean? Like, do we have like a line item for that? And do we have plenty of funds there for that? Like, where are we at on that end?
Well, you just started a new fiscal year. You're gonna save money on your destination management because it becomes administrative services. You're not gonna be spending $45,000 most likely, but you'll find that out on RFP. You also have event sponsorship. This falls to me in sponsorship. You can do events around this as well. And so it is advertising. So kind of for you all, it's in your advertising piece as far as that goes.
It seems like hopefully there's not going to be less events, but with, you know, currently less events and less, I guess, need to sponsor it, then we would have even more funds for this. Is that safe to assume?
That's safe to assume.
Okay. Well, I move to approve. I move to approve the opportunity to do a second mural. I can't read my agenda item, so I'll just leave it like that. I move to approve.
Here, let me move up here to the top. There you go. Additional $5,000 for the mural, additional mural, and maybe future discussion to expand digitally. That's something I want to just throw out there because we talked about that with Ashley and Zoe. So a digital walking map type of thing.
That was perfect.
Okay. So we've got a first from Amr. Do we have a second?
Yeah, I'll second.
I think they both seconded. We'll go with a second from Dina. I think Dina or Karina, either one, I think they both threw their name in. So we got a first from Amr and a second from Karina. Can we do a roll call?
Certainly. And I just want to clarify that we're approving 5,000 to move forward with the possibility of additional. Did I capture that correctly for the map, the digital map?
Yes, digital walking trail or digital, what do you want to call that? What did I say? Future discussion to expand to an exclusive digital mural walking tour.
Got it.
Good, Ashley. Yay.
Thank you. I appreciate the clarification. Board Member Alexander.
Yes.
Thank you. Board Member Sohi.
Yes.
Vice Chairperson Ketchum.
Yes.
Thank you. And Chairperson Harden.
Yes.
Motion passes. Thank you.
Perfect. Okay. Agenda item number 4, we've got the budget report.
Yes. And that would be me giving you your budget report. So the budget report, let me grab it real quick. I'm sorry. Kind of having to scroll down real quick. Let me get there. So their monthly budget, what I provided all of you is what we received from finance every month. I gave you June through June 2021, a full expense detail, very detailed report that kind of takes you through, I wanna say 12 pages or so, 14 pages of how expenses have come in. So you can see how the 2021 fiscal year budget shows all expenditures. There's also a second attachment that shows both your revenue and your expenditure summary. So if you haven't looked at it, do look at that. This is just kind of making sure that we stay on track. I'm not throwing it into the same Excel spreadsheet that Big Red had developed. I can do that. I wanted to get a feel from the board before I take the time to do that. I know you guys are used to seeing it that way. I don't know if that's helpful or not helpful. But if it's something that we want to see continued, then we'll want to keep it updated. However, I know that's a little bit more asking on the budget side when you're already getting this detailed information. We basically have three buckets. We have a consultation bucket, a marketing budget bucket or advertising, and then we have digital. We don't break it all out into all the different pieces for our budget purposes for the detail, but we can. So we're at kind of this crossroads where we can give more detail to our expenses that come from the city, and then you're not throwing it into an additional Excel budget. You're just seeing the same budget that you're supposed to see versus it looking different. But if you want to keep what you've had, we can do that. It's really up to you guys on how you want to do that. The TOT reports, the third report that's on there, you get that no matter what, have always gotten that report from us. So basically, if I scroll into here, all these pieces where we look at office expenses, we look at destination marketing services, you know, we're very big buckets where we're not like pulling it all into these little pieces. So you're seeing exactly what's coming in and what's being paid. It's very clear cut, clean, kind of taking you through what you have. And then let me scroll down. Don't look at the screen because it's going to mess with you. Then you get a summary, and that summary is consistent with what you guys always see from the city side, which is, I'll get there someday. You have your revenues, your expenses, and you can see exactly how we bucket those items. They're very clear, clean. They don't go into this was IBW, this was that. If you want to do that, that would be kind of that Excel document that you're used to seeing. Let me minimize this a little so you can see the whole thing. But this will give you an idea of how your year-to-date actuals happening with 2021. So you can see exactly what you spent in your advertising, in your contract services, and in your admin, which is the city side. So you can kind of see that there, as well as your net income and stuff. So it really depends on what the board wants to see and how much detail you want to look at each month. And with that, any questions that you might have, as I scroll down, you can see just how the expenses kind of roll
through. Yeah. As far as I'm concerned, this is more of what I'm used to as far as a budget's concerned.
I agree.
So, yeah.
It's a little
easier for me to understand.
And, you know, again, too, if we wanted to provide whatever level of detail that you guys want to see each month, we can do one sheet. We can do, you know, one sheet like TOT like this. So you can see what your revenues are and what we're ending at for fiscal year 2021. We can, you know, cut it down to just one page as a recap. And like Dina said, it's kind of what you're used to already seeing. I don't mind providing all the detail in the packet because at least you can see what came through that month and you can see all the detail, that expense detail's there and it's available and it comes out in a report. So it's really easy to do. It's already being done. So
yeah, that's much more meaningful to me.
Okay.
I mean, I don't mind. My eyes kind of got used to how it's been over the last, you know, several years. And I mean, I don't mind, you know, just sort of relearning and refocusing on a different budget. I do like the idea of having a lot of those individual expenses broken down and not in a more so categorized way. So if you're saying it's in a monthly report and it's visible elsewhere, just not, you know, like in our TBID meetings, like in this form, I mean, I can deal with that as long as it's visible somewhere. Like, I would like to see how much you spent at IPW, or I would like to see how much Cal SAE was and how it varies year to year. And again, for me, for my eyes, I had an easier time seeing it through Big Red's budget report, the way that they had their line items laid out. But again, it's just what my eyes get familiar with and I can change that. So that's not important to me. If it's easier to keep it on the same Excel spreadsheet, I'm okay with that. And I can just kind of relearn, but definitely I'd like to see the expenses broken down, detailed.
And what I can do, Amr, I can take this detail, like where it says operating supplies, we can make it look like that. We can add to, like in this area of what we call our job cost numbers, we can add what that is so you can see what they are. So I can take what you had before with Big Red and how they categorize, and we can add those categorizations to this. So when you're looking at it, you say, oh, there it is. Like for instance, here's our, you know, sponsorship donation for the San Luis Obispo Arts Council for $5,000. Like it's in there. It's just trying to maybe categorize it a little tighter. So when you look at it, it's similar to what you had with Big Red. It's just not in an Excel document. It's here in a, you know, expense document, but it's listed. I think that's what you're saying might be helpful and more important.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I feel like as a board, we didn't really look at the budget really that often. And the things that we did through our discussions, it was helpful where, you know, people would be like, what am I looking at? And we'd be like, you know, look at line item 5102. And we'd be able to scroll right there and look directly at that expense.
Yeah.
So again, as long as it's, you know, broken down and it's able to see and easy to see. And again, I can make my own adjustments. I'm fine with it. And maybe it's a matter of just trying in a short time. You know, I'd be able to see like it's here and it's clear and it's easy to find and easy to account for.
Okay, and I can probably export it to an Excel document. I can work on this a little bit more and then at the next meeting kind of show you where we are with it. So I'll do a little legwork between now and our September meeting.
Sounds good. Because you know what I mean? Sometimes we would look at it and many of us would be like, where am I supposed to be looking? And it was helpful just to see that line item, see it categorized as a number and the expense was right there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Definitely. Thank you. Any other questions?
Terry, I have a question. This is Brina. Just so that you don't have to reinvent the wheel, would Big Red be willing to send you the Excel spreadsheet that they put together that we can, you know, it's a running document that
I have everything right here on this. It was not really reinventing it per se. It's here. I can do it. I think where I feel most comfortable is taking what's actually coming in and being recorded into our system and then Excel it out the same way. Just, it's just a lot cleaner to look at. And I don't know, I'm not even going to look at Amanda because I don't want to make promises I can't keep, but I feel like I can work on something that's more, that will be more helpful, more categorized, that is already in our current system. So I can definitely look into that, but I have that Excel doc right here. So we could make that just as simple for the administrative services coming in to do.
I don't want you having to do more work than this.
Thank you. Any other questions? This is do you want to go to public?
Yep, can we get any public comments if anybody has any? Okay, seeing no public comment, we can close the public comment portion. And then is this a receive and file for this one?
Okay. Can we go back to that TNT? Nah. Because it looked great. And
yeah, I like the way that looks.
Yeah, for many, many quarters, we were like, yeah, let's not look at this right now. So maybe this is a good one to look at.
Very good. All righty.
Okay, so then if we're done with that one, we can move on to the updates, correct? So we've got the Visits Locale TMD update with Amr.
I don't actually have any updates. We didn't have a meeting last month.
Okay. Our
meeting is next week. So yeah, no updates.
Okay, perfect. So can we move on to the city business update?
Yes, so city business updates, just a couple things. Cruise night, Friday night. So we have right now about 150 cars registered. Normally we have about 200. Normally we have 400 cars total that will be cruising. So we're getting a lot of people coming in to register cars this week. That's normal for us. But we don't have the car show on Saturday, and I think that's going to play into the cruise as far as the numbers that we will actually have. But it will be a really nice cruise, really nice evening, and people are certainly excited. So it's going to be a nice evening for that. And then the next night we have Dancing in the Streets, again, a scaled down version. But it's making me a little nervous because I don't think it's going to be scaled down in the number of people coming out for it. Each of our concerts has been roughly around 1,000 people versus 250 people out at the Tuscadero Lake Bandstand. So with Steppin' Out being one of the bands along with Burning James and the All-Stars for Dancing in the Streets, it's going to be hopping and popping down here in Atascadero. We're not doing alcohol, so we're hopeful to send people out to Wild Fields and Dead Oak and Tent City Brewing and other places like that. So then that way they're supporting all of our downtown merchants. So we're open container. So now's the time to be able to push those people out to those areas. And hopefully it'll be a really great evening in the downtown. So we are also getting ready for a different concert with Patriots Day on September 11, because it falls on Saturday. We are doing more of a bigger deal. We're gonna have a flyover at 5:30 on that day from the Estrella Warbirds Freedom Flight. We'll also have the high school choir doing the national anthem, and we'll have Come Out and Meet Your Local Heroes. Both police and fire will be in their A uniforms. We'll have a fire truck out there with a flag, and we'll be also the police officers and the Chevy will be out there, the 55 Chevy police car. And then we'll have a Painted Red music or Painted Red band, which is three retired firefighters that will kick it off, and then we'll have unfinished business that comes in after that. So that's on September 11. And then we have our new addition to the Cornhole Tournament. We are doing the Ravine Water Park on the Friday night. And the reason why we're doing that is because we really want to give some more exposure to this event and get more people signed up for Cornhole Tournament on Saturday. Saturday's Cornhole Tournament's always been about 64 teams. We're shooting for 128 teams. We will have 40 teams over at the Ravine. We're trying to get the North County rivals out there with the Greyhounds and the Bearcats, and the mayors are going to compete. Mayor Steve Martin and Mayor Moreno are going to be out there playing cornhole. So we're getting a lot of that activity going for September 17th and 18th. And if that's not all, we all have our Central Coast Craft Beer Festival coming up October 23rd. And we got this Pata Bonton coming out to Atascadero to do his reggae thing on November 18th, 19th, 20th. That's your Atascadero Fall Fest. So we got a lot going on. We have holiday lighting coming up on December 3rd, Winter Wonderland, December 10th, Tamale Festival, January 15th. So it's busy. And so we'll keep out there promoting and doing all those things. As far as other things going on in the city, there's a lot of things opening and happening. And just with Zoe talking and having the block shops up and running with Negrante and the hat store, and we were talking about the Specs eyeglasses store over at Grape Encounters Emporium. I mean, there is constantly something happening in town, and it feels really good. And so on all sides of town too, we have new retailers down on the south end of town, Anna's Place, B&B's Clothing. We have all kinds, you know, there's just constant stuff happening. It's hard to keep up with, but we can do it. It's like drinking out of a fire hose, as they say. Our Rock Snake, Guinness Book of World Records. We should know hopefully something by the end of August. And once we find out a little bit more, yep, we're keeping our fingers crossed. We will then be working on a rock fest and trying to bring that in at a certain time of year that makes the most sense. I know that Josh has had huge success with the Passport for the Wine Festival, as well as he's bringing back the new Art, Wine, and Brew Tour on September 24th. So Josh, I don't know if you want to talk a little bit about event part, just to segue a little for city stuff and what the chamber might can add to that real quick.
Terry, you're on a roll. I do want to talk about Art, Wine, and Brew. Why don't you finish up and I'll go into public.
That sounds good. That sounds like a great place for it too. But I don't want to steal your thunder. So lots of things happening. I feel at this point we might have an opportunity to bring Phil back in and talk a little bit about Phil Dunsmore, talk a little bit about economic development. He had recently hired Lorelei Kappel to really, you know, work on the economic development side. I think maybe the next meeting we could do something like that if there's time. We've just had a lot on our plate to tackle right now with just the whole administrative side for TBID. But definitely feel like we're due for an update on all the things that he's working on behind the scenes. So maybe we can shoot for September or October to do that. And that's it. That's my conclusion.
Terry, I have a really quick question. The road closures for Dancing in the Streets, is it just Palma Mall and East Mall and West Mall?
Yeah. So,
okay.
It's East Mall, West Mall, Palma, up to Entrada, but they're going to allow that driveway to be open.
Oh, they are? My driveway in the back?
Your biggest challenge, and we can talk offline, is going to be cruise night.
I know.
It's they're trying to make it a little bit more open and flexible, so you don't have as much of a challenge with parking, but you still got the Entrada to Palma shut down to traffic way. They go around that way, is how they do. So.
Right.
That's it. That's all I have. Thanks, Patricia.
Terry, I just wanted
a quick update
on SloCal. Only I know, Umar, you gave your board SloCal, but just mentioning the EDI work,
work
that we're doing. So specifically for Atascadero, you guys contributed into a few studies. So we have our visitor research study and we're getting the results. I checked in with Kathy yesterday. I should be having some initial summary results at the end of this week. So that's really the pause. We're going into fall campaign creation mode, our team is, but we're really wanting to get the results from the visitor study to understand where we're at there, any shifts and adjustments. We also have the marketing plan. Kathy sent that over from Visit SoCal as well. So we have that to use to level up on. And then we also have the EDI component. So we should have some initial information. And then once I have that, we can build up the upcoming concept and then flow that into the marketing plan for this fiscal year. So I just wanted to give that quick update too.
Thank you. And I would leave you on there as an update. I took both yours off and the marketing committee because we didn't have a committee meeting. So that's why I took it off. But they did have their asset shoot and they were out at Three Bridges and did a shoot out there as well as the downtown. And that did happen August 4th through 8th. It was that time frame where they really did quite a bit with the beer trail, mural trail. They were doing all of those type of things. So they were out there shooting. Which is awesome. I know they got Ancient Owl Beer and Bottle Shop and that kind of stuff in there. So it was really good.
Yeah.
As part of that. And then events and festivals update, I could do that real quick too under city, because it kind of falls more under city, but then back to Visit SoCal. We did not take the approval to take the MOU to city council. I worked with Rochelle on that and we didn't do that because it didn't really identify who is responsible for the events and festival strategy. Is it city that's responsible for it? Is it TBID that's saying you're responsible for it and you're gonna implement it? Because it is so vague, we contacted Visit SoCal to let them know that it definitely needs more details in order for us to sign off an MOU that talks about cities gonna be implementing all this stuff. So we're not the only city. All of the other cities did the same thing. As you can imagine, Pismo and Paso for sure, because they, like, we have our event strategy, so do they. So right now, Visit SoCal, I talked to Melissa today and just basically they're revamping it. It's a work in progress right now for them. And they're going to be bringing it back in more of a phased approach and then really kind of working on what that MOU for the events and festival strategy looks like. But I wanted to let you guys know what is happening with that on our end. And then we'll have a defined plan and then most likely we'll bring it back to TBID to look at it again and then take it to city council. And then the city manager will make a decision on that. Or city council makes a decision on that. Excuse me, I misspoke. But that it'll go in the same path again. I just wanted you all to know. And that's why I kept it on future discussion items. It's not going to be anytime soon, but probably October. But that's why it's listed on future agenda items is for the number two. Now that's it, I promise. Thanks, Patricia. Thanks, Ashley.
I just want to say I'm really excited to have such a robust update. I think it's exciting that there's so many things happening and it feels a lot more normal again. So I'm excited, Terry. So thank you.
Yay for normal.
Yeah. Perfect. Do we have any board member comments or questions on any of those? Or do we need any public comment on that? Past what we did?
On the events and festival strategy, this is Brendan with Visit SoCal. Based on what Terry said, it's exactly right. We're moving toward a two-phased approach of doing a working group facilitation and taking next steps from there. So there'll be more details on that from Melissa as that gets finalized. That was all.
Thanks, Brendan. Do we have any additional board member comments? So we went through the updates. Any additional comments from board members? Do we need a public comment on this part? I can't remember on this one.
Nope.
No. Okay. Thank you. So future agenda items, we've got the two. I think you already went over the one with the MOU and then the other one was the political action topics presentation.
And that's just future agenda items. It's kind of keeping them out there that everybody knows is going to come back at some point. And then that way, I know the political action topics was Tom O'Malley talking about like an ad hoc with that. So that's why I parked it there.
Makes sense. Perfect. Okay. So do we have any additional board member comments or public comment at this time? All right, seeing as I think we're then ready to adjourn, correct?
Only thing I can think of is if Josh wants to say anything, now's your time.
Take it away, Josh.
I hate to keep everyone on the call, but I will. Art, Wine, and Brew, it's coming back. We're doing it. Deanna, this is going to be really exciting, especially for you. It's September 24th. We're calling it Fall Back into Art, Wine, and Brew. The information has been printed, and we're going to start our social media campaign and our print campaign starting next week. We have a web page already signed up, and we've already sold a few tickets. So we're excited about that. Again, September 24th. The chamber has become a mask distribution center for the North County. So if any of you or your businesses, actually it has to be a business, needs masks, you can reach out to me. There's just a quick little form you have to fill out that identifies the number of employees, the number of masks that you want, and the name of your business. And I've got 10,000. They just, while we were talking here, they just got delivered. I've got this giant pallet of masks, and now I need to get rid of them.
And they say visit a Tascadero on them? Just
I wish. I wish. You can write with a pen, Terry.
No, yeah. That's against our branding guidelines.
Okay. Let's see. We have a mixer tomorrow night at the Home to Suites Hotel with Kobe as our host. And we've got lots of fun vendors lined up for that. That's from 5 to 7 at Home to Suites. Come out and say hello. I know a big challenge that many of you and the people you represent are faced with workforce shortages. So we are actively pursuing putting together a job fair in Atascadero for mid-October. So it'd be a place for you to recruit just for your normal employment, but also potentially for holiday employment purposes. So I'll be looking for information regarding that. And then finally, we are wrapping up our destination guide and business directory. And we are spending the next 2 weeks wrapping that up. And that's gonna include information that talks about the town, our history, our hotels, our restaurants, our downtown, our parks and recreation, our events, and other quality of life, like call outs. So we're excited about that. It's coming along really well. And all of you will get bunches of copies to put in your hotels. So that is my update.
Josh, real quick, this is Dina. So the event on the 24th, is that going to be similar to the past where you sell tickets at City Hall and over at Grape Encounters, or how's that going to work?
Yes, tickets will be sold at City Hall and in front of Central Coast Distillery.
Okay.
Do we still do in-kind marketing for events like that? Like as far as whether it's like social media or a calendar, or do we still do that, right? Or anyone?
We promote events. Usually what we'll do is Terry and I, we talk monthly for our social media content calendar. So all events that are happening in town, we always make sure that we feature them in social, and then we'll usually put some boosted post budget to those events. Anything promotional like that usually requires a little boost budget. So we always like to fund that on a monthly basis.
And anything promoting the downtown, because we want to have a vibrant downtown to have a vibrant city. We're promoting a city of Atascadero too. And I'm making sure that burden, we work together to make sure we're covering all of the stuff, because there's a lot. I mean, it's no doubt. It's good. It's just trying to make sure that we're hitting on all cylinders for that.
Yeah, the other channel, we put out content on our e-newsletter. So monthly e-newsletter, we always make sure that we have event content there too. So two different in the own space and social. And then as well, Terry always is really good about making sure our events are updated on our website.
Yep. I just added Art, Wine, and Brew yesterday to the website. So I just need a picture. It's all good. We won't keep you guys for stuff like that.
Perfect. Any additional topics or comments from public or anything at this time?
I will say too that we are trying to revitalize a bit. So you heard Zoe say that she stepped down. We are stepping in an administrative role. So we're trying to rally the troops. We're trying to get people to sign up to participate on the new bid committee and kind of see where that goes. But we're not going to let it die. We're gonna revitalize it. We're resuscitating it right now. Right, Terry?
Yes, we are. Good job. All right.
Perfect. Well, then I think we can adjourn this meeting. And our next one's September 15th, right? Do I have the date correct? My calendar in front of me. Okay. Perfect.
Yes.
Perfect. So we can adjourn this meeting and see everyone.
30 minutes early. Look at that.
We did it, guys.
Nice work, Patricia.
Good job.
All right. Thanks, guys. We'll see you guys in September.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.